greatness. Woo!
This is a toilet, correct?
Yes,
you are dressed as a toilet.
Yes,
do you think this man is Canadian?
Everyone is Canadian. How exactly do you balance out watching anime and not being a complete badass?
What are you doing later?
I'm probably going to go to a bar.
Oh, really? Oh, what a year. What a difference 1 year makes. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, I am Ernie Liu, coming to you from Anime Next 2009. Basically, this is where the fans POV all began, right here. It was myself and Danielle Choi. Now I got three new panelists with me. I'll start over here to my left. Right over here to my left, this is...
Lisa Cornelius, Trenton, New Jersey.
Six years attendee, and our biggest fan here at Out of Time. Right next to me over here, obviously you know this face, Mr. John Odell. And then finally right here at the end, this is, put the mic up to it.
Cosplay comedian Joe, and I'm from South Jersey.
South Jersey. So we have basically a New Jersey sandwich, because we're from Long Island, the outside's from New Jersey. So
I was born in Jersey.
You were born in Jersey? No, I can't do that. Now, we'll start off, guys. What is your first impressions of the con? I'll start over here with you, Lisa.
Well, when you first step into the doors, it was definitely incredible with, like, a new area. And you can tell it's a lot different and a lot bigger for newbies and even for old school people who keep coming back. This is definitely a lot better than last year's due to the size. But other than that, it was pretty nice. First step in.
All right. How about you, Adele? What was your first impressions of the con?
First impression of the con? I'm just going to say cookies. The Doubletree, the hotel where it was stationed at.
Yeah.
Gave us free hot cookies when we entered, and we were very surprised and very satisfied.
They were good. They were pretty good, actually.
Because we were very hungry.
Yeah, they were. Joe, what is your first impressions here of Anime Next?
Well, this is my first year going to Anime Next, and so I'm not familiar with how it was like before, but it was definitely awesome. It's been the best con that I've been to so far that I've ever gone to. I mean, I've only been going to cons for like a couple of years, but still very good. This is one of the few cons that I knew about, the only one that I know about, that they actually have a Japanese live action movie room. I thought that was pretty cool. Plus, they also have like an open discussion room as well, so you can put on like your own little panel. I thought it was very unique. I also think it's interesting that there's like three different venues for it. And I think I heard that like Anime Central, that there's four different venues. I just think like it makes it unique. You know, when one space is not enough, just look for other spaces.
Yeah, I'll definitely agree with you on Anime Central on that. There are four different spaces that are there, but also here at Anime Next, there were three different locations. And unlike Icon, they were in walking distance. So what did you think about that? Because usually Anime Next is held in East Secaucus, New Jersey, a little bit further up north, about 30 minutes from here. And that was all like, it was the convention center, and then the hotel was just a short walk down. And that's where other events were. What did you think of this layout as compared to that?
I think it was a good idea, especially for like the card gaming and like the videos for everybody. The card gaming was much more quieter and relaxing, especially for the Yu-Gi-Oh! Tournament, which was yesterday, which was a big success. I mean, having the artist alley inside of the hotel kind of brought back memories from the first time I went, because it was all in one hotel room. Oh God, I'm so sorry. Keep looking at you. Yeah, like they all had it in one hotel, so that made it very difficult. But for this, it's much more easier for people, especially for claustrophobic kind of people. So I think it was a good idea to have it in nice, bigger locations.
So it's roomier, basically.
Yeah. More, much more relaxing and more home-like feeling to it.
All right, how about you, Odell? What did you think of this as compared to the other Anime Nexus we've been to?
I thought it was okay. It wasn't my preferred space, mostly because there was nowhere to get food outside of the convention center. Like every bit of place to get food was like right here. You had to like drive like 3 miles out there to get Subway or anything.
There was a restaurant inside the hotel.
The restaurant was like $20 for a meal. $20 for just like a piece of chicken right there.
I know. I mean, but if you're desperate, you know, it is costly. You can get it. Plus, it's also a bar restaurant, which is, you know, very cool.
I'll give it, a bar is always a good thing at a convention.
You'll need it.
Yeah, I'm sure that some people have. Now, Joe, I know this is your first time here at Anime Next, but how would you compare this to the other conventions that you've been to?
It's in three different places instead of one. And how it is different, I think, with here, let's see, how should I describe it? Here, there's just everything, I think, basically. Like, everything, like, you can look for. I mean, the registration was, like, you know, super easy, like, super fast. Oh, yeah. And, like, even, like, with pre-registration, because, you know, with some cons, it's like, even with pre-reg, you have to wait in line for, like, an hour or 2 hours or so. But here, you didn't get anything. I literally just, you know, walked right in and got my badge. So, it's just...
I agree with that. Yeah, registration was definitely easier than I thought it would be. Because over the past couple years that I've been here, I noticed that always the registration line is always out the door. Well, it always was down the steps and then under the garage, for those of you who've been to Anime Next before. Now, how do you compare, like, that to this? Like, how long did you guys wait in line to actually get your badge?
3 minutes. Exactly 3 minutes.
3 minutes. How about you, Odell?
I didn't wait at all. Yeah, I just walked right up, and I was like, here you go. Okay, cool.
Yeah. Did you actually have to go, did you wait in a line, or did you actually?
There was, like, one person ahead of us, and it was, like, a whole family. So I was like, let them do what they got to do. I got all my stuff out. Here's this, scan that, look at this. Here's your pass, write your name, put it on your badge, done. Fantastic.
All right. How about you, Joe? How long did it take you to get...
The same sort of thing. There was only one person ahead of me as well. Like, I just literally waited in line for like 1 minute, and you know, I just, you know, got right up, got my badge. And also another thing that's like really cool is that I lost my schedule, the schedule for Anime Next, and with some cons, like, they might be more difficult to get it, but with there, like, they were just like, oh, here it is, here you go, here it is. So that's another thing that's very cool. It's like the staff, like, at Anime Next is very cool. They're very cool people. That's another thing that I really like about this con. So.
Oh, okay. Now, we'll go on to the next thing is staffing here. Did you think there was, like, an abundance of staff? Did you think that maybe there were too many volunteers or, like, not enough people at certain places? Or do you think it was just staffed just right?
I think the staff was perfect. I had no problems with them. They were a lot nicer than last year, especially for the dealer's room. I had a question about a bag that I had, wondering if it was too big or not. They said, no, you're fine. Just go right in. I was like, all right, shoot. Thank you. Very nice group. It always seems to be a mix every year. Either they're really nice or really bad, but this year, they were perfect. I had no problems with them, so I'm very pleased.
All right, how about you guys? What did you think of, like, staff and the personnel here?
I thought staffing was pretty okay. Usually I tend to have a little bit of issues with staff, but they were generally very friendly, you know, as friendly as staff can be. But otherwise, there were no problems.
Okay, how about you, Joe? Same thing?
The staff was very friendly. It was very friendly. It also helps that that a personal friend of mine was working on staff. If any of you guys heard of a guy named Uncle Yo, he was also here. Like, he's a personal friend of mine. So it helped to have, like, a friend or two within staff. But yeah, everyone was very friendly. Everyone was very cool. I don't have any complaints.
Oh, okay. Well, now we'll get away from staffing and all that stuff. Let's go on to some of the main events that were... Well, actually, you know what? Let's go with the dealer's room first. Did you guys get a chance to go to the dealer's room?
I did. The only thing that kind of disappointed me was the prices for a lot of stuff that they had. Like, I was trying to get a cell phone charm from Soul Eater, that's the kid, and he was like $7, while like the minor characters were only $5, and that really bothered me. And there wasn't a lot of variety this year, which kind of disappointed me. I just shopped mostly in the artist alley, so I give it like a 5 for dealer's room. Sorry, guys.
Not enough, like, dealers there, you think, or it's just like... They just were pretty much, there were like the dealers there, but it were all basically the same thing.
It was almost everything was the same thing. The only thing that was good was the ADV films, they're having great sales for DVDs. For like six DVDs, $25.
Going out of sales soon, though.
Yeah, that's true. But, sorry, ADV.
Yeah. But you know, it's always a good thing when you get DVDs at low prices. How about you, Adele? Did you get to go inside the dealer's room at all?
Yeah, I spent quite a fair bit of time in there when I had nothing else to do. Purchased a few things. The prices were dealer's room prices. You're not going to get bargain basement prices even on Sunday. But I managed to pick up a few things at fairly reasonable rates. You know, you pay a little bit less. You don't pay for shipping, which you normally would pay,
yeah,
which is a very good thing.
That's a big thing, yeah.
But they do charge tax occasionally, and I find that strange. Some people charge tax, some people don't. But it was okay. You can't really expect too much more.
Okay, how about you, Joe? Did you spend some time in the dealer's room?
I didn't get a chance to go in there yet. I was going to this morning, but I was running late coming here. I actually checked out a couple of the panels, and I didn't get a chance, but I noticed just from the just walking like from the entrance, there's quite a bit of cool stuff. One thing I'm definitely gonna get though, like is a T-shirt, because I was actually up at Anime Boston as well, and I waited too late. I forgot to get a T-shirt, and I was so mad, because that's also like a very cool con. I definitely wanted to have a T-shirt from there as well. So I know I'm definitely gonna get a T-shirt from there, and plus like maybe I'm gonna get, you know, like a little, you know, a little something else, you know.
Hey, con T-shirts are always done well. Now, as usual, I think, as the people know me, I usually never get anything in the dealer's room. I never do, but I probably have to get something for my nephew, because he wants Code Geass for his birthday, so I have to go find him that in there. So probably after this, we'll do that.
Sure.
Yeah, there is a lot of Code Geass here. Now, how much did you spend in the dealer's room? I guess I can ask you two this question.
I think I spent about like $9 so far due to the Lucky Star graphic novel, which I couldn't get on Amazon, so I got it here, and they said, oh, that's only going to be $9.
Lucky Star.
I'm a huge Lucky Star fan, but probably later I'll spend a little bit more, just get a whole bunch of Pocky at WYSIWYG's. If there's one place in the dealer's room that I've never had a problem with, this.
I'm over there with this.
We're coming during this video in the name of the steampunk community.
Whoa, what do we? Why am I getting? Why me?
Because
I like him.
Because I'm here.
This is not our show.
What's going on here?
This is the world.
Hello, I am Locke Valor.
This is a steampunk crew.
Pirates everywhere.
Hey, led by me.
Yeah, he's just a random person that's following us around.
No, I'm leading you.
And we come and do this in the name of the steampunk community.
Hello. How is everybody doing today?
We are here to spread the word of the steampunk.
Hell yes.
Bring your steam engines. Bring your steam. Bring the power.
Long live the pirates.
So long live RL. Thank you very much. Thank you for making your statement. Now get out of my show.
It's my show now.
But what if we want to?
This is ours. We're pirates. This is what we do. We come
and give you a custom medallion.
Can I see it?
What
happens if I do want a cursed medallion?
I don't currently have one on me.
Oh, so you threatened me with
this. This is what we do.
Yeah, we do. What do you do? You just invade him?
Yes.
Invade other people's videos?
We run around, we commandeer videos.
Ninjas! Go get them! Go get them! Yeah!
You tricked me!
I did not trick anybody.
Dude, I don't
Holy crap,
anymore.
You're tall. All right.
Oh. You trying to trick us!
I kicked him in a trick. Holy dear God.
Yeah, he's really dead.
He's lying.
Turn the camera off. That just went bloody for television.
Keep the camera rolling, please, with the deal over God. I don't know
what
to do here. Ooh,
this.
I like your name tag here. There you go. There's a foam sword here.
No! Why? No! No!
You know what? I don't care anymore. Here's your foot. Right. We have another gun.
There you go.
I'm not dead yet.
Pull him off!
Right, so I'll take his pole.
Sorry,
guys. Come on, we killed him.
Take the pole with his life force!
Save the captain! Save the captain!
Da-da! Da-da-da! Da-da-da!
That was pretty interesting there. Alright, so the steampunk community just punked us.
We got punked.
That's for sure.
Yes, they did. Now, that will go on to another thing. Whoa, what was my train of thought? Panels, yes.
Panels.
Let's go to panels now. Did you go? Let's see, we'll start off with you. What panels did you go to?
I actually attended my first panel. It was for the Access Power Italia, which was incredibly funny as hell. The group was great. If you got a chance to see it, you were very lucky. I had such a blast just going in there, chatting it up. There was questions, there was fan art, they were showing video footage from some of the music videos that have been made in Japan. Very good panel. Other than that, I didn't get a chance to go to the Anime Next Forum panel, which I'm kind of disappointed about, but then again, shit you gotta do.
Exactly. You can only do so much in one place. Maureen, she likes Access Powers. How about anything else did you do? Any other panels, or that was
it? That was just it.
All right, how about you, Odell? Where'd you go to?
I went to a few panels. They were mostly fairly interesting.
Yeah.
Some of the highlights were the Bad Anime Bad panel, which went through some of the worst anime ever made with some of the worst dubs ever created in human history. One of them, which I saw before I had to leave, was Dracula, Sovereign of the Damned.
There's an actual Dracula anime?
Yes. Well, I wouldn't call it an actual Dracula anime because I don't think Dracula eats cheeseburgers in Bram Stoker's book at all. And it was just really bad. I did go to a very, very good panel. I've been to it 2 years. It's called Writing Unique Heroes and Memorable Villains.
Okay.
It's done by a man named Mookie from the webcomic Dominic Deegan, Oracle for Hire. It discusses how to make really awesome heroes and really memorable villains, as in the title states. The heroes, you know, you don't want to make the big muscle guy who's always lifting weights. You want to make the guy that's just kind of standing there, or as Mookie said, you know, hey, you, short order chef, you're going to have to save the world. I have a spatula. Yeah, but I also went to the rave. That, I don't know if that's a panel per se, but the rave was pretty cool.
The rave was fun. That's all that. We'll get into that later, but how about you, Joe? What panels did you go to?
Some panels that I liked was the History of Anime panel. It was more like a workshop. It was in the workshop room.
Yeah.
But it went over, well, partially the history of anime, but also compared anime to American cartoons. I thought that was really great. This is the first time going to a kind of had an Adult Swim panel. And that was pretty good. And also, speaking of panels, I actually did a couple of panels of my own. Yeah, I actually did, I did a couple of anime comedy panels. Well, basically, there were stand-up performances by yours truly. And most of the panels that I've did were like 30 minutes and other cons. Anime Next was the first to give me two full-hour panels. I did a general ages stand-up. I did an 18 and over stand-up for those, you know, who wanted to hear jokes without having to worry. So, and they were.
It's a little dirty sometimes. You gotta have the 18 and over.
Exactly. You have to have the 18 and over because I actually had to, because it's, you know, quite hard to, you know, sometimes to really be funny without, you know, even getting into that area. But, you know, my general was sort of okay, but I really, that was the front I had first, but the second one was the 18 and over, and, you know, that, you know, I think it's sort of like, you know, I don't get a chance to go to, like, cons a lot, obviously, or few people can, you know, really go, because it would break your bank, so I try to perform at cons whenever I'm able to afford to, because, you know, I'm just starting out, like, I'm not as famous as, Uncle Yo, but this was good. I feel like I'm finally, these panels are good because I finally felt like I got the flow this time. I felt like I really got into it. Plus, with the full hour, I was able to say like all the jokes and say everything that I wanted to say, which was definitely good.
Oh, that's always a good thing there. Now, some of the panels that I went to, yes, I actually did go to a panel. The Super Mario Brothers panel, that was pretty funny. I'm trying to think of what other ones there were. I think my stereotypes are better than yours. That was actually quite bad. I thought it would be kind of funny, but it was actually, sorry guys. And then I think one other panel that we definitely have to discuss is the cosplay dating game. That's always a fun one. And actually I got a chance to interview the winners of the first game of the cosplay dating game. So here you go, check it out.
My lady.
I'm Kintaro Oe from Golden Boy.
And one of these.
Because I haven't seen many Wedding Peach cosplayers, and everybody knows that the power of love is the strongest.
Right, connects to the power of study, of course.
No, yes.
Alright, now you just did the dating game. How was it?
It was very fun.
Although very hard to hear anything.
Yeah.
Yes.
A lot of baby energy going on here.
What?
Oh, no. Now, what makes you pick?
Don't be upset, but half of my choice was directed by guess, because I could hear only half the answer. Yours were one of the ones that I could hear the clearest.
I have a big mouth.
Alright, so those were the, that was the couple that won for the cosplay dating game. Would you guys ever enter that?
No, I wouldn't, because I already have a boyfriend, and that would be really creepy. Because I've already been hit on like a ton of times at the con already, so it's like, no, that's okay, I'll pass that. Thanks.
Alright, how about you, Adele? Would you do it?
Is this like a date where I don't have to pay for anything and I still get something at the end?
I can't guarantee that.
I guess I could take my chances.
Take your chances? Alright, how about you, Joe? Would you ever be in the cosplay dating game?
Yeah, definitely. I think it would be very good, and yeah, and I noticed that, like, I haven't been going to cons that long, and I noticed that, you know, a lot of these girls who cosplay, you know, are really good looking. So if I could go into the cosplay dating game, you know, I think it would be, I mean, actually I haven't been in it yet, so I'm not entirely familiar with the format, but with how it sounds, you know, definitely, I would definitely love to check it out.
At least give it like a shot or something.
Exactly.
Like that. Alrighty. Well, now, another thing, now we're going to go on to the main event, since we're talking about the cosplay dating game. One of the big main events that they always have here is called Cosplay Burlesque. And it's basically where they have cosplayers, they dress up, but they strip down. It's more of like an older ages masquerade, is the best way to describe that. Did you guys go to it or no?
I didn't even know about it, actually, to be honest. If I knew about that, I would have gone, I think.
Not yet, Mike, but you know what?
I'll talk.
Odell, well, you didn't go to Burrow. Yeah, you were there.
No.
How about you, John? Did you go to it?
No, I didn't even know about it myself. So wait, it's like these...
basically like an older ages masquerade.
Like a striptease, almost.
Yeah,
striptease. Oh, yeah, like that. I would imagine, like is it, like... Do they have, like, sections for guys and girls, that way they
go? Yeah, it's guys and girls, so...
Yeah, so I imagine, like, once they would get to the guys' part, that all the fangirls would go nuts, especially if it's a character that the girls really love, you know?
That's exactly what happened. And actually, I had the chance to talk to one of the girls involved with the show, and here she is.
I'm Lily Stitches. I'm with Cosplay Burlesque. And there's lots of people here, and I'm looking at them when I probably shouldn't be.
Okay. Now, what exactly do you do? What is the cosplay burlesque?
We dance as cosplay characters and take off our clothes.
Now, you did this last year.
Yeah.
Why didn't you bring it back this year?
Because it was a huge hit, and we have a great time doing it.
All right. Now, is this your show different from last year's, or is it something completely
different? It's a bunch of the same people, but we're bringing new people in, new dances, new acts, so it's different.
Alright, so those were one of the girls involved in the Cosplay Burlesque show. Now, another thing that happened in the main events was obviously the big one, Cosplay Masquerade. Lisa, did you get a chance to go see the masquerade?
Oh, of course. That's like the main thing I want to go to every single year. But unfortunately, this year, it just wasn't that great. I mean, there were some great skits. The Revolutionary Girl skit was incredible. Once again, those girls kick ass. And the Marvel versus, I guess, the sexy guys of anime skit was great as well. That one was pretty hot. But overall, there just wasn't that great, unfortunately, you know?
Yeah,
I'm very sad about it. So.
It was only an hour long, so yeah. That was including skits and walk-ons. So it's kind of like you had to stretch it out a little bit, stretching a lot of turkey meat there. How about you, Odell? Did you go to the masquerade?
I did not go to the masquerade because I had pizza waiting for me in the room. But also
disgusting pizza, by the way.
But I did go to the masquerade last year. I don't know if it was any better, but yeah. Based on my experience last year, decided kind of not to go.
You made a good choice.
I did go to the anti-masquerade, or I forget exactly what the name of the panel was, but
it's like anti-masquerade extravaganza, if my memory
serves.
Yeah. Anti-cosplay masquerade extravaganza.
Try saying that three times fast.
I thought I just did.
No, you didn't. Okay, anyways. But how about you, Joe? Did you go to the masquerade?
Yeah, I went to it like probably like around the middle, like probably like towards the end. I mean, I have a question. Like, did you notice like where it gets like really good in the beginning and then started to not be so good the longer that they went?
In the beginning, it was just really like the beginning kind of felt like it was dragged out. I mean, everybody tried to do their best on the skits. It just felt like it felt a little flat, you know, like climbing up the ladder up. Slip right down, you know?
Yeah, well, I didn't see, like, I came, like, towards, like, the middle and, like towards the end. But I guess the one, like, the sort of complaint that I sort of had is that, like, once they, I didn't know, like, when they stopped doing the actual skits, when they started doing the walk-ons, it was difficult to tell. Like, I kept asking myself, like, are they doing the walk-ons now?
Well, the walk-ons, they mix it up. So it's, like, instead of, like, you will have, like, two skits and then a walk-on and then two skits again, walk on, like do three skits and walk on. So they spread it out, so it's a mixture of both walk-ons and skits, which I personally think is not, like, they shouldn't do that.
Yeah,
at least it gets confusing, like you just said.
It's confusing to the audience, like, and I don't think that's fair because a lot of the audience, that was confusing to the audience, and I don't think it was fair because, you know, like a lot of the guys were like, a lot of the audience was booing when they didn't even know that it wasn't supposed to be a skit, it was just supposed to be a walk-on. Or if they're going to do that, at least announce that it's a walk-on, because I just feel sorry for these guys that got booed and they didn't even, you know, I mean, they didn't choose to have it in this format. I personally think they would rather have it, you know, when they know that it's a walk-on, so that way the audience doesn't think, you know, that, oh, it's just, you know, a very bad masquerade skit. So that's the one thing that should definitely change for the masquerade if you're going to do that. Either announce it or just have a separate section for it and then announce it. So that way, you know, good people who do good skits, you know, don't get unfair treatment.
Very true there.
What they would do in previous years, what they do in previous years was they would do all the walk-ons first and then they would actually start the whole masquerade that way. They would just go walk-ons first, skit second, but I guess they just decided, we don't have many walk-ons, let's just put them all together in one, just mush it up. It doesn't always work that way though.
Yeah, I noticed that. Like they did that with Anime Boston. It was some do it before, some do it after. I personally think that they should do it if they're going to do it like beforehand, so that way it's sort of like a warm up to the masquerades and stuff like that. And plus, like I said, they have people like in the doing the walk ons, you know, don't, you know, see like all of these, you know, like masquerades skits and might feel uncomfortable because especially like on stage, like you know how easy it is to get stage fright. So we would need to make, you know, so just make it like that, make it before, so that way everyone can feel comfortable doing the either skits or the walk-ons that they worked so hard to prepare for, because it does take a lot of work to put these together. I don't know. I actually did do like a mini, like in Techo Shokan 2008, that's when my first stand-up was. It wasn't a masquerade and it was like a 2-hour skit, but you know, it was very, you know, nerve-wracking, like, it was my first time, and I know how nerve-wracking it can be.
Yeah, some people can get it, like, they'll get up there, and then they've rehearsed this entire time, and then all of a sudden their knees buckle and be like, oh, that's it, we just totally forgot what we were supposed to do. But if you guys didn't get a chance to see the masquerade, there's a wonderful thing we call the montage. And basically, here you go. Here's some of the highlights from the masquerade here at Anime Next 2009. Please don't stop the music.
I wanna take you away.
those are the highlights from the masquerade. Now we're gonna move on to a different subject, the artist alley, because I know you wanted to talk about that a lot, Lisa. And this year, the artist alley here is actually was really good. I was because a lot of artist alley I've seen, they were like, or down the drain. But this was actually pretty good. I actually bought something from there. I have a little picture of Elle breakdancing. But how about you? What did you get? Because I know you like the artist alley a lot.
Well, most of the stuff that I actually bought this year was not from the dealer's room, like you said, artist alley. Like the Yaoi spatula, which was made by my friend Saya. There was only two available. So
bad.
And of course, the artwork is just incredible that they have. I have one friend named Smart Gem. Her artwork is just fantastic. And if you guys haven't seen her stuff, definitely check it out. But besides that, they had, I don't know what we call it. I guess it's like beads made out of like different characters from video games and anime and stuff. I think it was like geek mythology or something. Their stuff was just gorgeous as anything. I wanted to pick up something, and it's a Pac-Man bag with like the Pac-Man going around a circle of the purse, getting the pellets, and then of course getting the red ghost. But besides that, I liked the diversity that they had. It was much better than last year, because of course last year was in a parking lot and you couldn't really see everything. But they really did an amazing job, and I hope I get to see all those people again next year.
All right, Odell. Well, to you, did you go to the artist alley?
Yeah, I did go to the artist alley. My buddy Mookie was there selling his wares, his scarves, and his books, and doing autographs. I saw a lot of nice prints for sale. It seemed fairly average to me in terms of an artist alley. I'm used to Otakon with the big artist alley.
That's Otakon. You can't compare this to Otakon.
Well, I know you can't really compare it, but what is it? They also had the charity auction there, I believe it was. They had a few nice things there. You know, nothing too memorable, but it was still some very nice art from some very good artists.
The Lego Nest was pretty cool at the auction one. If you guys get to see the Lego Nest, definitely check that out.
Okay.
I think it's badass.
How about you, Joe? Wait, did you get a chance to go to the artist alley or not?
Yeah, the artist alley, right by panel rooms 1 and 2, right?
Yep.
The artist alley, like, is amazing. Of course, all artist alley, like, is amazing. Like, I'm always amazed at, like, the guys that can, that can create, like, fan art, like, this good. In some cases, it almost looks like the real thing. That's one of the reasons why I'm attracted to anime, because of, you know, just the look of it. But, yeah, some of the artist alley was really good, and in fact, I might actually go down there and get something. Like, when does it close? Like,
I think it closes at, I think, 3 today. I'm not sure. Maybe
3. Okay, three. Then good. I'll be able to get something from there. Because yeah, I definitely want to pick up. There was one picture, two pictures that I remember. There's the one of Sora. You know, the one of Sora.
Oh, yeah.
Like yeah, that he was going on. I'm not sure if you see it, but it's awesome. It's incredible. And one of Cloud Strife, like with the anime eyes. They're both of them look very cool. That among many others. You know, there's just literally like too many to name there. So yeah, whenever you go to a con, definitely check out the artist alley, and you'll be amazed at just at the creative talent that these guys have. And I really tip my hat to them.
Alrighty, well, that's it for pretty much the artist alley there. They are talented artists, and we salute you on that. Now, one of the big things whenever you come to Anime Next, or just any anime convention in general, it's always the cosplayers. Always the cosplayers. Those are the ones that you want to see when you get here. So, I'm going to ask each one of you, who is your favorite cosplayer? And I'll start off with you over here. Lisa, who is your favorite cosplayer?
Well, from what I saw last night after the masquerade was over for the hallway cosplays, I don't know what anime it was from, but it was this couple. Actually, yes, now I remember. It was from Tsubasa. It was Faye, Sakura, and Shouron. And they had these beautiful long dresses, and they hand-painted the flames of the outfit onto the dress. And it got them the win for Best of Friday Night. And they were also the winners for the Revolutionary Girl skit, of course. Those guys have amazing talent. Oh, and the Zelda from, of course, Legend of Zelda. Amazing outfit. She had a cardboard. It made it look like it was real gold that she was wearing, like real jewelry. Just incredible cosplays this year. I can't just pick one. I have to pick like a few.
Alright. How about you, Odell? Who's your favorite cosplayer? And you cannot say yourself because you were cosplaying as somebody on Saturday.
My favorite cosplayers I actually just saw today. It was the group from the Team Rocket recruitment station. A bunch of guys dressed up in Team Rocket uniforms trying to get people to join their group. I thought it was very inventive. I love seeing stuff like that, especially a little skit to kind of go along with it. I love seeing people get together in a group as opposed to just like one guy. And it was really nice. I thought they, you know, had a lot of spirit and it was really good.
All right, well, how about you, Joe? Who is your favorite cosplayer here?
Well, my favorite cosplay, I can't say like any particular one, but I did see the Tsubasa Reservoir Chronicles one, and that was pretty cool. The one I also think was cool was the guys, like, all the cosplayers who dressed up like from Code Geass, like Lelouch, Suzaku, and all those really guys. And also, I really do like these couples who like cosplay as like a couple from an anime. I think that's very sweet. That's very nice, and it's very cool. So that was cool. Also, on a side note, this wasn't my favorite, but I've noticed that there were actually a couple of people dressed as a Shindo from Gravitation, and the first time I saw it was the last con I've been to, Anime Boston. Saw three of them there. I saw two of them. Like one of them, like who was a guy who was cosplaying as him, and so I thought that was kind of interesting. Oh, and by the way, in case you don't know, I'm cosplaying myself as Dark Mousy from D&D Angel. If you see the series, then you obviously familiar with him.
All right, how about you, Leo? Who is your favorite cosplayer?
There are so many that go out there, but I love the people who you think are cosplaying and really they've just wandered in somewhere from Hot Topic.
Yeah, I'll give you that. Yeah, those are always good.
I forgot to mention the one girl who was dressed up as the Cake is a Lie from Portal. Her cosplay was just so incredibly cute, and I love how it was like a big giant cake, had a little cherry on top, and of course carrying the sign that says "This cake is not a lie." So I forgot to mention that one. Love your cosplay.
Of course, the cake is not a lie. Now, usually with every convention that we go to, there's always a gimmick question that we ask, and we ask cosplayers here at Anime Next if they had the chance to give any anime character they want steroids, who would it be and why? Here is what they said.
I'd probably say Jigglypuff, because now I can picture that little round head on top of like this huge like Mike Tyson body, like running around with a deep Jigglypuff voice, just like beating the hell out of everybody with its bare hands.
I'd say Sasuke from Naruto, because I'm tired of hearing him whine all the time.
I'll give it to my character. Because, should I say it? I want these two characters to be a couple.
Oh, okay.
And my character's too young, so I'll give him some steroids.
Wow. I don't know. That's a really oddball question.
I don't know. I guess Alan Walker. He could use a little more, I don't know, muscle to really kick some ass.
Monkey D. Luffy, just to see what would happen.
Bad plus Night Luffy.
I want to see what would happen if you got like the little innocent character became really strong. I think that'd be an interesting thing, but we don't want to destroy the innocents, we still want to keep them cool. I don't know.
If there's a character I would recommend, I would want to see on steroids, it would have to be Haruhi.
Do we really want that?
Yes! Yes!
I don't think Haruhi on steroids.
Because it would make her physically unstable, and I'd love to see what the world would become.
The name escapes me right now.
From what?
Neon Genesis Evangelion.
Shinji
Ikari. He needs to get some roid rage going on there because he is definitely the wimpiest character ever.
Probably Sebastian from Kurosu Tsuji because he's so badass already that with steroids, everything, the world would just come to an end and hell would take over.
I would think Sora from Kingdom Hearts because even if he hit puberty in Kingdom Hearts 2, he still is kind of girlish and feminine and he needs to be more manly.
Awesome because it'll just look funny. Dawson, because it'll just look funny. From Street Fighter.
I agree. Dawson looks like he's in a little bit of need of buffing up his Street Fighter. He looks like he could use it in the fight.
Who would you recommend?
Who would I recommend? I would like to see Pikachu.
What? Why Pikachu? Ryu. Put Ryu on steroids.
Why Ryu?
Why not? Why not make him bigger?
as it is, so make it super duper big.
Yeah. Or just get the Burger King on steroids. He's not an anime character, but he scared the crap out of everyone.
I don't know. I don't know if I have an answer to that.
Steroids, Sailor Moon. Because she's a weak bitch. Yes, she needs to get some steroids and just kick some ass for once.
Not really.
I like the crazy characters.
Okay. And the crazy ones usually are already strong.
They don't really need it anyway.
Yeah. They need Ritalin more than they need steroids.
Maybe Sailor Moon, so she get pumped and have real powers.
Luffy. Because he looks too skinny. I don't care if he's made out of rubber. If he took steroids, his muscles would get big, and when he punched with the rubber thing, you'd be flying for miles. You would never stop flying.
Dr. Salvador. Because him on steroids is Mega Dr. Salvador. Two chainsaws.
Chris Redfield, so he would blow up.
He already did get on steroids.
Yeah, but then he'd explode.
Yeah, and plus he's not an anime character. I give it to Shinji explode. Just because I'm tired of hearing him whine.
Kira!
Ulakura from Bleach.
I want to see him happy.
Yeah, I just want to see him buffed up.
Yeah, I want to see
he's
him
kind of lanky.
I want to see him buffed up. He's like sad lanky all the time. And he's sad. Maybe if he got like muscles, he'd be happy.
Oh god. Light Yagami.
Oh, my light.
Yes!
I think he needs it. I don't know. Just for L.
Sailor Mars. Totally. She'd be a beast on those.
Oh my god, she'd just be running down the street just ripping people apart.
Ripping their limbs off. It would be awesome.
Sailor Jupiter, definitely. She's already a man, basically, so might as well make her muscular.
Yeah.
Probably Krillin from Dragon Ball Z, because he dies all the time.
Kamina from Gurren Lagann.
Oh my god.
Manliest of all men.
Field. Because Chris Redfield has ginormous arms.
Chris Redfield from?
Resident Evil. Especially 5. He's gorgeous.
I'm gonna say Vin or what's his name? Kingdom Hearts. Like, Roxas. Roxas needs steroids. He's too wimpy.
Probably Yuffie from One Piece, just because it'd be hilarious to see.
Good. Give steroids to Corporal Guerrero from Kiroro Gunso. Because Tamaman's usually the one who goes all super sati, but Kiroro has an inner strength that I want to see come out. But then again, I don't want his testes to shrink, and I don't want him to lose his hair. Maybe I wouldn't give him steroids.
Oh my. I'd actually probably give Shinji from Evangelion steroids, just because he seems like such a just a pushover, you know, nobody respects him, but if he was all ripped, you know, he might get a little bit more respect.
Alright, so that's what cosplayers here at Anime Next think. How about you guys? Which anime character, if you had the chance to give them steroids, who would it be and why? I'll start with you, Lisa.
That's a really good question. Oh god. I would have to say Ness from Smash Brothers Brawl, mainly because I think if he had that bat, he'd be like Barry Bonds with the bat.
Oh, okay.
For Smash Brothers Brawl, of course, so yeah. It's a very good question, though.
Oh, thank you. All right. Well, I can see that. All right. How about you, Odell?
I'm going to have to say Broly from Dragon Ball Z. I just want to see if he pops. Because his muscles are already so big, because apparently his power is maximum. So if you give him steroids, let's see how far he can go before he turns like a balloon and just goes.
Alright, how about you, Joe?
One or two characters, either Link from the Zelda series, obviously, because if he had, you know, powerful like super muscles along with his other abilities, he'd be a force unstoppable. Also a force unstoppable would be Luffy from One Piece, because with his gum powers, if he had like super muscles there, he would be completely unstoppable. Like he would literally find like the One Piece in like 1 week or something.
Alright, so interesting there. My personal preference, I would like to see Pikachu on steroids. Because you get to see a big manly boy go Pika Pika. So I always thought that would be very interesting. Come on, don't lie. See someone this big and like built like Mike Tyson or something like that.
I am Jack.
Exactly there.
Mike Tyson's Pikachu.
Exactly there. Now we come to the part of the show that I'm sure some conventions don't like, and that's ratings. From a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the lowest, 10 being the highest, what would you rate this convention and why?
It's like, warning! Especially for the forums, because I know the forums are going to be more brutally honest than I'm going to be. I'm going to give this con actually an 8 due to the, well, the high points, of course, is the new area. The area was really nice, really clean. Love the area. But the down points, like I said, Masquerade wasn't that great. The dealer's room could have been a lot better, because I know the Artist Alley is going to get a lot more sales than dealer's room. No offense to those guys, but yeah, definitely an 8, especially after previous years. This one is just not that great. Sorry, guys.
Alrighty, how about you, Odell? On a scale from 1 to 10, what would you rate this convention and why?
I'm going to rate it a 6, slightly better than average. I've been to a good number of conventions. There are certain things I liked and certain things I disliked. I disliked the pricing. I disliked the lack of amenities in the hotel, lack of fridge, lack of microwave. Oh, no wireless. There was no wireless internet in the hotel, which was not fun. But in terms of the actual convention, there's a bunch of really nice people. The costumes, you know, they aren't that great, but, you know, I did enjoy a lot of the events that I went to, some of the panels. The rave was pretty fun for the time that I was there. Yep. I met a lot of cool people. I took some good pictures. I usually never take pictures. Yeah. But it was generally fairly okay.
All right, well, how about you, Joe? From 1 to 10, what would you rate this convention and why?
Well, from a non-biased point of view, like if this was, didn't go to con, I would say a 9. From my biased point of view, a 9.5, because like I said, I live in South Jersey, so it's actually within driving distance. I didn't even have to get a place. Like, it only took me about an hour to get here, so with that, like a 9.5. So there was a lot of things I did like. I definitely did say, and I do agree, yeah, the Masquerade could have been better. There were also some problems, like one of the panels rooms like had to be moved to like where the video room is, and even though it's a walk, it's still like a 10-minute walk with that. And lastly, the thing is, they really need to keep their panel sign-out sheet open past 11 p.m. because I had a panel that's my 18-over panel was at 10 and I was at 11, so I couldn't sign out. Actually, I have to go do that so I can get my compensation. So, well, like I said, and just also that thing with the Masquerade about the whole announcing the walk-ons versus the skits, so that way people don't get booed again. But those are really my only big complaints. Other than that, it was a fantastic con.
Alrighty, well, I would probably give this maybe a 7.5 because it wasn't. Usually Anime Next is my favorite convention out of all the conventions I've been to, and for some reason I felt like they dropped the ball on this one. It wasn't as good as the others, but I guess maybe it's just like I just didn't do as much because I was just doing a lot of filming there. But it's also like I think they're trying to get used to the whole new system here because they did move to a bigger place, they did move to a better area, and yeah, and also the other thing, our hotel kind of sucked, and also, yeah, there's no food nearby, and $17 for a breakfast bar is way too much.
Some advice for that?
Yeah, but you're staying, what, a minute down the road over here?
Yeah, not even like a minute down the road. If you guys come back next year, definitely go to Homewood Suites. They give you free breakfast, free internet. You get like this huge ass room with a kitchen. You got the microwave
seat.
Dishwasher. Definitely way better than the hotels that they have here, and really cheap, only $79 a night. So yeah, Homewood Suites for next year, you guys.
Sounds pretty good.
Sounds pretty good. So remember that, John. Homewood Suites. We will remember that.
Yeah, and just one last thing with it. Yeah, whenever any con moves to a new location, it's never going to be perfect the first year. There's always going to be some errors, mistakes. You have to get readjusted to the whole setup. So you know, you have to give it that sort of handicap whenever going in there. Not be too partially judgmental of that. So, with TechoShokan 2009, they also moved to a new venue, and there were some problems going on there.
Yeah.
But it was like fantastic. It was like because I went there 2008. It was like in a hotel, like in one hotel, and then they moved to a regular a convention center. And so it's much bigger. It's, you know, you have to walk a lot more, and you know, you have to get readjusted. So remember, always remember that if a con is in a new place this year, try to give it, you know, a little bit of slack. So
yeah, okay, I give you. I see that. So any final thoughts before we close out for Anime Next?
I just want to say a big thank you to like all the people that I keep seeing every year. The staff, you guys are always working your asses off. To all the people in the Artist Alley, you guys keep up the good work. I can't wait to see what you guys come up with next year. And especially the only reason I always keep coming back to this con is not for the dealer's room, not for the masquerade, but the people that you meet. Everybody I've met here for the past 6 years have been some of the nicest people ever, and I really appreciate being able to go here and have long lasting friendships that last even after this convention is over. Just want to say thank you to all you guys.
Alright, very well put. How about you guys? Any final thoughts?
I really enjoyed it. I got to spend some time with some great people, a lot of my friends, which is usually the best times that I have when I'm with people. It was a blast for what it was, and I would definitely come back again and enjoy the festivities one more time, even if it was held here.
Okay, and Gigi, are you
mad? I just want to say that I definitely want to come back here next year. How about you guys? Do you want to come back here?
Yeah, that was another thing. We're definitely coming back, right?
Definitely coming back next year, because even with some of the few flaws that I have, this is the best con that I've been to so far, and so I definitely want to come back here next year. And it's great, you do get to meet a lot of new people. The guy behind me, who of course goes by the name of Uncle Yo, is actually one of them. We actually met at a prior con. But yeah, I mean, that's just the thing. Yeah, in general, like meeting new people, you know, building friendships, just being able to see everything, and just being able to see like us, like the anime community. Like, it's a very good thing, and especially good like if it's within driving distance. That way, you know, you get to save a little money and not have to get a place. So I'm not familiar with the lack of amenities with the hotel, but definitely, I would recommend anyone else definitely come and check out Anime Next 2010.
Definitely check that out. All right. What we have now is a trailer on where the fans POV is heading next. So check it out. So the fans POV will be coming to you from Anime Expo from Los Angeles, California, July 2nd through the 5th. Make sure you check out dates for that during our closing credits. I want to thank Lisa, Cosplay Comedian Joe, and John Odell. And I want to thank these guys over here, the Steampunk Empire.
Steampunk Empire!
Thank you to them for invading our show a little bit. Here you go, this is the final montage. This is a song you guys chose at home for the ending montage. I'm Ernie Lee, thank you. Make some noise, Anime Next. There you go.
Just好きなような好き好き好きなんだ take out the dude with the white hair.